Charlie Ross is the creator of One Man Star Wars Trilogy, which is coming to the Apollo Theater Wednesday through Saturday of this week. He's a big Star Wars fan. I'm a big Star Wars fan. I have my girl right here, Princess Leia, on my shirt so that she can be a part of this interview as well, too, in spirit. There we go. Charlie, welcome back to Chicago. You've been coming here for almost 20 years doing the show. Yeah. 2004 was the first time. I mean, what does the show mean to you?
Oh, what does my show mean to me? I think actually more specifically, what does Chicago mean to my show? Because my show was just a little thing that I was performing and, you know, kind of touring through fringes. But when I started to perform it at like a legitimate theater, that happened when I went to Chicago. That was the first really legitimate run I ever had of my show. And it was kind of terrifying because it wasn't New York City, which was great because that just seemed weird to go there. Chicago was like, it had way more history and had a history of things that are cool, having a chance to percolate and become cool. And I just kind of felt like, wow, cool. I'm actually in a city that where cool things happen. And for some reason, media gave me way more attention than I wanted, which was great because Lucasfilm found out about me through being there in Chicago. And when they found me, they didn't kill me, and that was also good. In fact, they were kind of intrigued, and I kind of feel like Chicago was the gateway to my life. So being able to come back and perform it is sort of returning to the place where the magic really, really occurred. It's a bizarre thing.
And when it first started, so let's talk a little bit about how Star Wars became a big part of your life. I remember, you know, as a kid, I mean, that was the movie I watched. I finished it and I wanted to rewind the VHS and start it all over again. You memorize the characters, the universe. That was my experience. You know, what was it like for you?
I just thought I was all alone. I thought it was just me that was sort of experiencing this, this love, this, you know, this kind of imprinting into my brain and into my heart. Weirdly enough, growing up though, you know, you meet kids that also like it as much as you. Over time, it kind of gets supplanted by the next big thing, but there was always Star Wars fans. It's like Star Trek fans. It was sort of something that was sort of flowing through their blood. And I think that's kind of where this show has its basis, because people moved on with their lives. Even people that were huge Star Wars fans, they started to do things and become different, you know, jobs. But when we come back to our love of Star Wars, it's like returning to that time when you first saw it. You know, and for me, I lived on a farm. So when I was on this farm, we didn't have TV reception. We had a VHS player. I had a copy of the very first Star Wars movie. I watched it. I'm sort of, you know, ashamed to say over 400 times. And then when I moved away from there, somehow theater came into my life. And I think this sort of combination of peanut butter and chocolate kind of just came together. And flash forward many years later, I had this weird idea along with my director TJ to do this weird show. I just didn't think it would work, and I'm wrong. I mean, it did work, because somehow just those little moments all captured together to kind of, you know, bring it forward. Now, like, I started doing the show, as you said, before YouTube was a real thing. And if I tried to do it now, imagine I tried to do it right now, it would probably have its viral moment and then be over. But I was sort of that weird crossover, the analog performer, the analog life moving into the digital world. And I've somehow managed to stay analog, which is kind of great.
Now let's talk a little bit about what the show is. You play all the characters. How many different characters do you play? How many voices? Tell us a little bit about the show.
Well, the show is me on stage, no costume, no set, no props, no talent, just me. And, you know, I'm wearing arm pads. I wear like kind of this crazy looking jumpsuit, like I'm a crazy, you know, garage mechanic or something. And I play, I don't know, maybe 35 different characters, you know, the main ones, if you can call them the main ones from the films. And I retell the original trilogy in about an hour. So no costume, no set, no props, huge editorial jumps. There's wacky sort of, you know, jokes that I put in. I hate saying the word wacky, but there's just jokes that you've probably thought of before, but I just punch you with it at the right moment. And I've had almost 20 years of getting it right. So I guarantee it, even though this is sort of right up your alley, if you're a Star Wars fan, you will get it. And depending on how much of a fan you are, you will really, really get it. And hopefully, I hope you come and see the show and say, darn it, I wanted to do that same thing, because I've had more people say, I had that same idea. And well, that's great, but I got there first. So anyway.
Exactly. Because I think that's part of the joy of that is that a lot of us, you know, grew up watching the movies over and over, memorize the lines, memorize all the scenes in order. And this is our dream. We're watching our dreams, you know, come on stage when we see you.
Oh yeah, okay, but keep in mind that, I mean, it may look like a dream, but I mean, it's hard work. Yeah. Your dreams can be hard work, harder work than you might think. And you know, as with every dream, comes just sort of the reality of approaching that dream. Like, I didn't actually have this dream that I was going to do a Star Wars show. It kind of became something that took over my life. I thought I would just be an actor doing Shakespeare or something pedestrian, I think. This just kind of took over everything. Like, I'm not even an actor anymore. I'm just this Star Wars guy. You know, like, I have nothing at all in the way of any skills. So be careful what you wish for. You might just sort of say, well, you know, a pandemic hits and then, oh, no live theaters, no job. Uh-oh. So I guess, you know, work on the side of the street begging for nickels for, you know, Chewbacca impressions or something.
Oh, exactly. But now you're coming to Chicago Wednesday through Saturday.
That's so right.
We have a couple of chances to go ahead and see you. Do fans dress up when they come to the theater?
Absolutely. In fact, the greatest people in the world, the 501st, the Star Wars Trooper Garrison. I met the Midwest Garrison. The very first troopers I ever met were there in Chicago. In fact, Kathy Van Buniken, John Duffy, Mike, Amy, a whole bunch of people that have come to my show, and they'll be actually at my show in costume, proper Star Wars looking, you know, costumes. They are part of this massive global costumer club, and they're all, you know, licensed by Disney as well. They'll be out in costume. So if nothing else, you'll see somebody that looks way better than I do there in the lobby before the show.
And just a big shout out to them as well, too, because not only do they do wonderful things in the city, but they go to children's hospitals. They go a lot of charity events. They do a whole bunch of great stuff in Chicago. And anytime that we've ever needed them or there's something going on, they're one of the first groups to go out there, and they're an amazing group of people.
They truly are. I mean, as far as there being a club that embodies the spirit of not just fandom, but of Star Wars and the giving back of something that's done so well, these are people that they live the love, and they really take their passion for not only making, you know, Star Wars costumes, but just for being kind, good people and celebrating the love, which is the final little lyric there. Celebrate the love. Yup, yup.
Oh, exactly. Now let's talk about the Chicagoland area. Harrison Ford from the Chicagoland area, George Lucas, part-time living here. He's, you know, always spotted downtown somewhere as well too. Has anyone from the Star Wars trilogy come to see the show?
Well, I actually had Anthony Daniels just recently actually saw the show when I was in Pittsburgh. I had no idea. It's before the show, somebody asked me that was there at the theater, you know, there's a special person associated with Lucasfilm, or rather with, you know, Star Wars. He's there in the audience. Do you want to know who it is? I said, no. And they go, oh, okay. And then they came and told me like 2 minutes before I was starting to do the show, you know, no pressure, but Anthony Daniels says, don't let anybody know that he's there in the audience. I'm like, well, why would I have known he was in the audience unless you told me? Anyway, he came up after the show, like when I was on stage thanking people, he came up onto the stage while I was there. And we both basically talked to the audience for about 45 minutes. And we ended up performing like bits, not only of my show, but of other Star Wars stuff. So I was playing with C-3PO on stage. It was crazy awesome. Yeah. Anyway, but I've had Wicket come see the show. I know that Mark Hamill has seen a whole whack of it. I've had a lot of the producers see the show. I had Boba Fett come see it. I mean, various others, even George Lucas, I know, has seen some of it. I'm not sure if he sat down and watched the whole show. He's a very busy guy. But when I had to get licensed way back in the day, I had to submit him a 5 minute and a 15 minute and then the full show. And I know that I got the A-OK. So he's seen at least some of it.
He's at least some of it. I do want to ask you about Anthony Daniels. At what point did you spot him in the show? And what was the fan reaction once he just like got up there and people realized it was him?
Well, when he got back up there, when he got on stage, I mean, it was just sort of like the whole place went quiet, but I could feel the audience vibrating. It was crazy because when are you ever going to see a Star Wars star, if not the biggest Star Wars star, by virtue of the fact he's been in every single one of the things. He's been in everything. And he's sort of the most legit part of Star Wars in the sense that they've never had to replace him in that way. Anyway, he was there on stage and it was bizarre because I had tried to do my best to make the voices and everything, but then here's the real voice itself. It just seemed like it was legit moment, in Pittsburgh. It was so, so bizarre. And he was able to tell us stories that were, that were wonderful, that he may have told, a thousand times to groups of audiences, but we hadn't before. It just felt so special. And I kind of wish that I could have told that little kid who watched Star Wars, even tell, yourself that one day you're going to meet these people that they feel like they're a galaxy away. And when you realize just how human and normal they really are, it's a wonderful thing, because whatever kind of dream you might have that seems totally unattainable is in fact terrestrial and is attainable. It's just that, your dreaming is big and, as those stars seem, but when you can touch them, you kind of go, wow, that's crazy. Maybe I could actually touch my own dreams. I could actually achieve them, whatever that happens to be. It just makes it feel like, and it made it feel like bigger things were possible having him there. Can I just tell you about my, this is the most bizarre moment, wonderful bizarre moment I ever had. I came off the show, the stage. I was at a convention it was a celebration convention that was down in Orlando. I came backstage to the green room, big, big space, and it was getting a water. I just finished the show. I looked just revolting. And there's a couch with some people sitting on it that are talking. And I was just getting my water and drinking my water. And I kind of turned around and there was Mark Hamill, George Lucas, John Stewart, and Carrie Fisher all sitting on the couch, just chatting with each other. Because of course they were coming up next to do this talk. Anyway, I remember just sort of drinking my water and they're not 10 feet away. No one's really looked over and acknowledged me totally. So I just sat there and drank my water and I pretended that I wasn't existing just so I could be there and listen and bask in it. And when I started to look around the green room, there was a person over there and a person over there and a person over there. And like yourself, there was probably about maybe four or five people pretending like they were just holes in the universe, nothing at all, so they could take in as much of this as they could. And then eventually, I guess it was John Stewart kind of realized that there's all these lurkers. And he just sort of got everybody up off the couch and everybody just started to sort of intermingle around. And it was fine. It was fine. It seemed bizarre. I had nothing to say because what could you possibly say to any of them? I just thought, I want to be here and just experience being in the same sort of ether with them and just have this moment. In fact, it was probably better not to try to engage because I would either feel like an idiot or I would be an idiot. And, either way, it would feel the same. So just having that moment to feel like we were all in the same vacuum seal, it was great. And I get to carry that for the rest of my life.
You get to carry that. Hopefully, you may have a photo or two of that experience as well, too.
Not even one. No, in fact, nobody was allowed to take any pictures.
Well, you got the mental photo right up there, too.
Right there.
Yeah. And most importantly, right here as well, too. Charlie, thank you so much for your time today. One Man Star Wars Trilogy coming to the Apollo Theater, 2550 North Lincoln. ApolloChicago.com is where you can go ahead and get those tickets. He's going to be here for several nights, Wednesday through Saturday. And go check out this show. If you love Star Wars, if you want to challenge it, if you want to think mentally of like, do I remember the movies in that exact order? And just, celebrate the love of Star Wars here in the Chicagoland area. Yes. Thank you so much for your time today.
Thank you.